Hi, I'm Brett Evans with MotorOne.com, and as you can see, today is not a normal day. I'm here with a 2022 GMC Hummer EV, and I cannot wait to dig in and get a closer look at this truck's interesting details and features. Come on with me. So as you can see, the GMC Hummer EV is a very modern take on the original off-road Hummer formula, starting with this beautiful light bar up front. As you approach the vehicle, it turns on. You got that beautiful Hummer EV illumination. It's a little bit different from the old Hummers. Before, you had the Hummer word mark set on the front grille, separated by 7 individual grille slats. And of course, this is an EV, so it doesn't need grille slats. So instead, you just get 6 individual elements, separated vertically by those 7 pieces of trim. And then as you can see, there's a really beautiful H motif in the front headlights as well. That's more obvious when you turn the headlights on. And it's a very good looking, very modern piece of machinery. These headlights also tell you a lot of really interesting information, such as when you're charging the vehicle, they display the state of charge. Each one of those segments represents a portion of the battery that's being charged. So when the entire headlight is illuminated in blue, you know the battery is ready to go. Obviously, there's also turn signals, and this being a very modern Hummer, it's got sequential turn signals, such like you might see in a Audi product or maybe the rear taillights of a Ford Mustang. It's really pretty good looking. And then it also has a big, beautiful front bumper, very, very distinctive and very appropriate to the Hummer family lineage. All right, so this being an EV, that means you don't have a big, massive internal combustion engine up front to make room for. And that gives the GMC Hummer a very impressive front cargo carrying abilities. So with a normal truck bed, obviously you've got your stuff open to the elements unless you have a tonneau or a topper in place. But with this, you can put all your dirty stuff, things that you're not really worried about getting messy in the bed of the truck, and some of your more precious things, valuables, purses, backpacks, briefcases, stuff like that, in this lockable, secured Frunk. And that really opens up a lot of cargo carrying ability and versatility, which is definitely important to truck buyers. Not only is the Hummer EV a 21st century machine in the powertrain, it's also very modern suspension-wise as well. This is a standard air suspension that offers up maximum fording depth of more than 30 inches. They haven't told us what the maximum ground clearance is, but they have said that it can scale an 18-inch vertical wall with this air suspension all the way up. That is really, really incredible. And as you might expect of a Hummer, it's just very heavy duty underneath. Very high quality looking machinery. That's only gonna get better as this thing gets closer to production. That bracket holding the sidestep up, as you can see, that is a thumbs up. You want to keep that thumbs up intact, because if you're flipped, it turns to a thumbs down. That's such a hilarious detail that no one is going to know about, but this is just too cool. Just kind of shows how much detail they put into making this thing interesting and cool. Wheels have a beadlock effect that definitely tied in with the original high mobility multi-purpose wheeled vehicle Humvee. Whereas before you might see an H1, H2, or an H3 on an old Hummer product, on this machine it says Hummer EV. And just overall, it's a really, really attractive truck. So moving to the rear, you can see that there is a very distinctive kind of classic off-road Hummer shape to the taillight. And this chimsel as well boasts an H mark too, which is pretty cool. It kind of echoes the headlights as well. There's a lot of H imagery all around this thing. Now, in addition to that, like other premium GMC products, the Hummer EV boasts the multi-pro tailgate. So just like the Sierra Denali and other Sierra products, you have a bed step setup with the inner tailgate down and the bed step retracted. You can kind of make it easier to load. You can step closer to the bed. This bed step also operates as a load stop depending on what position the tailgate's in. It's really just a very versatile piece of machinery. And when they first announced this on the GMC Sierra 1500, it kind of seemed like a gimmick, like it wasn't something you were gonna use all the time. I can say from personal experience, having driven many of these trucks before, when you have the multi-pro tailgate, you miss it when it's gone. The details on this thing abound. As you can see up on the C-pillar, there's a really beautiful American flag motif. And check out this interior detail. So this is a topographical map of the moon. You can see a little astronaut's footprint. They say this was modeled after Neil Armstrong's footprint on the moon. You can also see that on the dead pedal. There's a little Neil Armstrong footprint. And then another topographical map on the interior center console storage. And then of course you've also got this beautiful infinity open air roof, two individual panels over the front row, two individual panels over the rear. Lots and lots of air in this thing. It's really, really attractive. Looks like it's gonna be a lot of fun to drive down a trail or even just down the highway.
Now obviously, you know, this is a pre-production model, so it just kind of has a video static display rather than an active display. But as you can see here, we've got each of the vehicle's off-road modes, lots of different information that you can derive some insight from when you're off-road. This terrain selector has a very clear crab mode. We're also not totally sure if it's going to come with traditional four-wheel steering. In my mind, I think that would make a little more sense than crab mode off-road. The only time that I could really see crab mode being useful is if you have to traverse a mountain from the side instead of going straight up or straight down. But, you know, I'm sure it'll help with maneuverability in some ways. I still personally would like to see very traditional opposite phase four-wheel steering, though, when I'm out off-roading. But, you know, that remains to be seen. By the way, you've got a Super Cruise indicator right here, too, because the Hummer EV is going to have Super Cruise available. I think it's going to be standard on the Edition 1 that I'm sitting in, so that's pretty cool. And it's the second generation Super Cruise, which includes, you know, automatic passing maneuvers as well. But sitting in this thing, it's really kind of amazing. Even though it is pre-production, everything feels very high quality. Those HVAC vents are really, really solid and bulky, and they feel great. You know, got a really nice texture to them. This grab handle is really wonderful. Feels very beefy and very sturdy. That's really nice. The steering wheel is gorgeous. There's definitely some GMC touch gear in here, but switch gear in here, but it's not terrible. It's not egregious at all. The rear seat is similarly spacious and it probably draws inspiration from the GMC Sierra in that it has just a ton of space back here. So you can see there's plenty of rear leg room. It's a big wide rear bench with a center armrest in the middle. I think it's going to be a really, really nice place for five passengers even, not just four. I'm really pretty impressed that they were able to pull this much space out of this thing. Especially given, you know, I'll tell you a secret. It's not nearly as big as I thought it would be. I would be surprised if it was even as large as a previous, you know, iterations of the Hummer. I'd be surprised if it was even as large as an H2. Of course, there are always a few caveats. You can't have it all. You can't have something that's as stylish and capable and interesting and zero emissions as this without compromising on something. And in that instance, I believe it's going to be price. You know, the absolute base model Hummer EV is going to start at $79,000, just over $79,000. But that's not going to be available until 2023 or 2024 at the earliest. In 2021, when this thing launches, it's going to carry a base price of $112,000. And all of them have already been sold out for that first model year. All the Edition 1 vehicles have been sold out. So if you want a lower priced Hummer, you're probably going to be waiting a while, and that's a shame. The GMC Hummer EV goes on sale in fall 2021 with the starting price right around $110,000. I can't wait to see this thing out in the road, but more importantly, I can't wait to get behind the wheel. Thanks for watching.